Good morning, Black Shout.
Good morning.
And to our viewing audience, this is another day that our God has made. And we come out here this morning to rejoice and to be glad in it. Amen. Let me say that again. We come out here this morning to rejoice. But I also come out here to share with you our occasion this morning, our special occasion. And let it be known that it is all about Him. Whether we now know it or whether we've known it all the days of our life, it has always been a truth. And that is that it is all about Him. We come out here this morning to lift up the name of Jesus. We come out here this morning to make a joyful noise unto the Lord, to serve the Lord with gladness, and to come before His presence with singing. Knowing ye that the Lord, He is God. And it is He who has made us, not we ourselves, for we are His people and the people of His house. And we are ministers in His gate with thanksgiving and into His courts with praise. And be thankful and bless His name. Because the Lord, through His mercy and everlasting and His truth, endure to all generations.
Seven times a day do I praise thee because of thy righteous judgment. Great peace have they which love thy law, and nothing shall offend them. Lord, I have hoped for thy salvation, and done thy commandments. My soul hath kept thy testimonies, and I love them exceedingly. I have kept thy precepts and thy testimonies, for all my ways are before thee. Let my cry come near before thee, O Lord.
Yes.
Give me understanding according to thy word.
Yes.
Let my supplication come before thee.
Yes.
Deliver me of thy word. My lips shall utter praise when thou hast taught me thy statutes.
Yes.
My tongue shall speak of thy word. For all thy commandments are righteousness.
Yes.
Let thy hand help me, for I have chosen thy precepts.
Yes.
I have longed for thy salvation, O Lord, and thy law is my delight. Let my soul live, and it shall praise thee.
Yes.
And let thy judgment help me.
Yes.
I have gone astray like a lost sheep. Seek thy servant, for I do not forget thy commandments.
Yes.
Thank you.
worship service. Amen.
Amen.
Office, please come forward. Glory be to God. We thank God. We thank God for all that He has already allowed and saved and done in His sons. And much has already been saved and done just by being able to walk into this place. Once again, see faces sitting in the sanctuary that hadn't been seen in over a year. To look out across the congregation and see our mothers. Worship and praise God with the Black Shepherd and sharing out his church family. And to see members that I hadn't seen in over a year, you know, that's priceless. You can't put a price tag on some of the blessings that God bestowed on us, because they can only be bestowed by way of God's grace and by way of God's mercy. And let it be known, each of us and all of us are here because of that, because of God's mercy and because of God's grace. And the Lord tells us, He loves a cheerful man. This is a time we pause for a moment and give thanks and recognition to those who are less fortunate than we are. As always, the Bible tells us that the poor shall be with us always. And this is a time in our worship service where we thank God for providing us with provisions in which we ourselves have been given stewardship over, that we may reach back and lend that helping hand, that loving hand, that each and every one of us, at some point, sometime in our life journey, is going to need someone who's out front to pause, turn around, and reach out and extend and lend a hand. I would love it.
Good morning, my shepherd.
Good morning.
I said, good morning.
Good morning.
We ought to be primed up,
yes, sir,
and ready to turn it on. Yes. If you go down to the good, give us a break. We didn't have to do it. Okay. Yes, Lord. So glad. Yes. Let us go into the house of the Lord. Yes. Oh, God has been so good to us.
Yes.
He's been so good to us over the past years and years. You know, a lot of us that were with us long ago are no longer with us.
Right.
Some of us in this very congregation of you and Ian almost didn't make it.
Almost.
But by the grace of God, they are here. By God's love, they are here. He said, he never leave us, never forsake us. But God sent his only begotten Son to the world, not to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved.
Yes.
And even when he died and rose again on the third day, that those that believe in him as the Lord and Savior may have everlasting life. But the Father, he sent the Holy Spirit to comfort us. That's right. And we need to reflect on how good that God has been to us. Let us also show that same love to one another, not only to the saints, but also to the servant that may serve you. Give a kind word, okay? Because it's the evidence of our faith in Christ is the actual love that we show to one another. And that brings us to our scripture reading this morning in Colossians, the third chapter, the 12th through 17th verse. We find Paul speaking to the community of the Colossians, but it talks about the Christian virtues, and it reads, "Put on, therefore, as the elect of God, holy and love, vows of mercies, kindness, always of mind, meekness, long-suffering, forbearing one another and forgiving one another, if any man have a quarrel against any, even as Christ forgave you, so also do ye. And above all things, that put on charity, which is the bond of perfectness, and let the peace of God rule in your hearts, to the which also ye are called in one body, and be ye thankful. Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly, and all wisdom, teaching and admonishing one another in songs and hymns and spiritual songs, singing with grace in your hearts to the Lord. And whatsoever you do, in word or deed, do all in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God, and the Father by him." May the Lord add a blessing to the reading and hearing and the doing of his word.
Oh, yes.
Let's bow our heads as we go to the Lord in prayer.
Hallelujah.
Oh, Father God, we just thank you for this opportunity once again to acknowledge you for who you are.
Yes.
And we thank you, Father God, for watching over us last night, the rain, Father God, and bring us all here safely. Father God, we have no good deed of our own or anything we've done, Father God, but only from you that we are here, Father God. We just thank you for all you've done, for what you will be doing in us, Father God. Help teach us, Father. Teach us to do the right thing, Father God.
Yes.
Teach us to love one another, Father God, as you have loved us, Father God. We just ask you, Father God, to guard our hearts and minds. Keep us, Father God, on one accord, Father God. We lift up our pastor, Father God, and his family. We thank you, Father God, for the fervent prayers, Father God. We thank you for his perseverance. Father, thank you, Father God, for letting him see your face daily, Father God. Speak us to us, Father God, as your word. We also ask blessings, Father God, encouragement for our ministers, Father God, our evangelists, our office of the church, Father God, our black family, fresh out of heaven, Father God, and friends, Father God. We just give you all the glory, all the honor, all the praise. And these things we do ask your son, Jesus Christ, name. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Amen.
That's all right.
Amen.
To be slow to take offense,
but always ready for reconciliation.
without delay.
To secure it without delay.
We moreover engage.
We moreover engage.
That we'll be removed from this place.
That we'll be removed from this place.
We will as soon as possible.
We will as soon as possible.
Unite with some other church.
Unite with some other church.
But we can carry out.
But we can carry out.
The spirit of this covenant.
The spirit of this covenant.
And the principles of God's word.
And the principles of God's word.
This concludes our devotion for this morning.
Amen, everyone. Amen, amen, amen. I don't know what you all come to do, and I don't know about you, but God is still in charge. He's still in control. He's still who he says he is. How many of y'all just looking around are glad to really be in the service today?
Confess that Jesus Christ
that when the offering bucket passed our way, we were able to give back.
Yes, sir.
Give back in love.
Yes, sir.
Give back in knowing that it is more blessed to give than it is to receive. We thank you, Lord God, for blessing us in such a way in which we were able to contribute to assisting those who are less fortunate than us as they journey through this wonderful, beautiful land which you created, made, placed us in. Those who may not have had funds to contribute this time, we pray your financial blessing upon them so as that the next time an offering tray passes their way, they also will be able to carry out the desires of their home. And that is to be a blessing unto others. We pray that this offer go forth to fulfill the required nourishment which was received. In Jesus' name, we do indeed pray and give thanks. Amen.
Mary Magdalene. When Jesus saw his mother there, and the disciple whom he
right now, God. And God, you always stand willing, ready, and able to supply us with whatever the need of our moment may be. And God, we never ever run short of substance. Amen. As they would put it, a cup running over, God. A God who is able to give you not just enough, but an overflow of whatever the need of your moment may be. And right now, the greatest need that we, the people of God, have right now is to lift up the name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. There's no greater need that we, the people of God, have for us right now than that of lifting up the name of Jesus. Because He is worthy. He is worthy to be praised. I know we have some challenging days behind us. We are in the midst of something right now. There are plenty more lies ahead. But God, will never leave you, nor forsake you, but will be with you always, even to the end of the day. And when God is with you, more than the whole world ought to get you. Let us never forget, no matter how great the need, one plus God, you plus God, always give you little chance. We can't lose my chance and visit friends if you don't. We cannot lose with God on our side. What a God. Let's give the Lord a round of applause. Let's give this great choir in our music session a round of applause. And before we receive our tithes, at this time, let's introduce our minister of music. A woman who really needs to go to God. A woman who is filled with God's Spirit, with His blessing, with His grace, with His house, with His gift. It will all be needed on time. What is a shepherd without sheep? He's a non-shepherd. Let it be known. I say it once and I say it again and I get joy out of sin because it's a truth. And it's a truth that each and every one of you should know. And that is that you're very valuable to God. You are irreplaceable, unsubstitutable. You can't be substituted nor replaced. And the reason why you can't be substituted nor replaced is because God only made one of you. Out of all God's making, and God made and created everything, but out of all God's making and out of all God's creation, God only made and created one of you. You're one of a kind. And that is the way in which we should view one another, in knowing that it's not another one. And that means that we should take the best of care, show the most admiration, respect, honor, and praise, and thanksgiving toward each and every one of us. As an individual, and each and every one of you, part of a collective group, but represents an individual. Amen. You're priceless.
Amen.
You're precious.
just so blessed to have you part of this collective group, which is known as Black Chapman Children Baptist Church family. Never again will that statement go out again about this being, about there being no room in the inn. That's been whosoever will let him or her come, and no lives will return your way. There's room in this inn. Yes, it is. Because Jesus has made it room. He's bigger. He's broader than the universe. Whether can I go from the spirit? Whether can I flee from his presence? If I ascend up into heaven, thou art there. If I make my bed in hell, thou art there. If I take wings of the early morning, flowers of the rose, part of it, even there, his hand is there to hold me, his right hand is there to guide me. We serve an omnipresent God, whose eyes are always upon and ears are open to, and hands are always outstretched. Shame come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give unto you rest. Rest. A peace which surpasses all understanding. That can only be rendered up by God and God alone. It is time for our tithes and offering. Lord, let us come at this time and give us a new seed.
Regardless of what has happened in the past year and a half with the Father, we are all we're here because of your greatness, dear Lord.
Yes,
and we want you to know that we appreciate you and we love you for it.
Yes,
we love you, dear Lord. We love you. We love you. We always will.
Yes,
and Father, we pray that you bless the offering that we're about to make, dear Lord. And we pray that you bless the officers to use it in a way that is pleasing to you, dear Lord.
Yes.
Father, we pray that you bless this offering, multiply it time and time and time over again. And we pray that you touch every heart in here, that they would give and give cheerfully, dear Lord, and not have to look back on what they gave, and not have to look and say that, I wish that I had kept that so that I could put some gas in my car. I wish that I had kept that so I could buy me something to eat. I wish. Father, touch them so that they give, and not look back on me, dear Lord. For it is yours in the beginning anyway, Father. It's not ours. It's not that we got to do our own strength, our own mind, our own will, our own talents, our own education, dear Lord. It's all because of you. All because of you, Father. And Father, we pray. We pray, dear Lord, that you forgive all of us, all of our sins, and cast those sins into a sea of forgiveness and remember them, Lord. For it is in your God and Son, Jesus' name, that we pray and give thanks. Amen. Usher, you are in charge of our tithe and offering. Don't get tithe to be in 10% of your earnings. Amen.
congregation, as I see you walking around, I see and I feel in my spirit that we're in the house of the Lord, but we're a little shell-shocked. It's like we have experienced the worst of the worst. If you've ever seen a movie and you see something, a disaster happen, and you see the survivors come through and they have this blank look of this stare on their face and they're shell-shocked. They can't believe they made it through. I just want to ask, do you see me? I see you. Do you see me?
There's no greater
greater symbol of life than blood. Blood keeps us alive. Jesus shed his blood. He gave us his life for our sins so that we wouldn't have to experience spiritual death. Now, 6 and 23 in Romans tells us we don't get paid for sin. But he said that the gift of God is eternal life through our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. I'm going to be reading for us here this morning, this afternoon, from the book of Hebrews, the 9th chapter, the 16th through the 24th verse.
Yes.
Yes. Pray along with me now. For the word of God reads that, for where a testament is,
yes,
there must also of necessity,
yes,
be the death of the testator.
Right.
For a testament,
yes,
is a force after men are dead.
Right.
Otherwise, it is of no strength at all while the testator liveth.
No,
whereupon neither the first testament was, yes, dedicated without blood. For when Moses had spoken every precept to all the people according to the law,
yes,
he took the blood of calves,
yes,
and of goats,
yes,
with water and scarlet wool and hyssop, and sprinkled both the book and all the people, saying, this is the blood of the testament which God hath enjoined unto you. Moreover, he sprinkled the blood, both the tabernacle,
yes,
and all the vessels,
yes,
of the ministry.
Yes.
And almost all things are by the law purged,
yes,
with blood.
Yes.
And without shedding of blood,
yes,
is no remission. And we thank God for his word. It was therefore necessary that the patterns of these things,
yes,
in the heavens should be purified with these.
Yes.
But the heavens themselves with better sacrifices,
yes,
than these. For Christ,
yes,
is not entered into the holy places made with hands,
yes,
which are the figures of the truth,
yes,
but into heaven itself.
Yes,
now to appear in the presence of God for us.
Yes.
So God has done this thing for us.
Yes.
Bless his holy name. Bless his holy name for the blood. Bless his name for the blood.
Thank you.
we're in the midst of what we call a cup full of church.
Amen.
And that is a cup that should never run low. A cup full of church. A cup full of hallelujah Jesus. A cup full of thank you Jesus. I'm washed. There is no greater accomplishment that one can make in life . You may hold the record for running the fastest mile . For scoring the most points in a basketball game. For being the greatest boxer that ever lived. For being the world's greatest musician. The world's greatest soloist. The richest man or woman in earth. But there is no greater accomplishment than one can accomplish in life. And it is one of the most simplest works in which one can work. For the reward of that simple work is a reward that only God Himself can give. You don't have to be a super athlete. A world-renowned musician. A great track star. In order to accomplish the greatest work in which one can accomplish in a lifetime, all one has to do is confess with one's mouth and believe with one's heart in the Lord Jesus. And that God raised him from the dead. And thou shalt be saved. Jesus asked his disciples, what will a man profit? What will he profit? If he gained all the accolades in earth from all the other works that he has shared. All the accomplishments, regardless of what one's status may be in life, what will a man profit if he gains the whole world and loses his soul? Or what will one give in exchange for one's soul? And that was to go man's own.
to let our path lead man from his sin into the lawless life, back into the will of God. What a walk he walked, what a work he worked, what an accomplishment he made. I come but to do the work of my Father, sit there. And his Father's will has not changed.
Yeah. More.
in the world is going on in this place. Because it's been silent for so long. Well, you can even almost hear a look as you fall.
In place.
ahead for it. It's behind us. It's already been done. And he's going to keep on doing it over and over and over and over again because he's the same God yesterday, today, and forevermore. He changes not. I'm asking once again, let us not forsake the assembly of ourselves together. Next Sunday morning, we're going to be over for worship service. We're going back to our regular service. I know we may be a little late today, but this is the first day. We've been at this sanctuary for 15 months. And we just want God to know what he already knows. And then we're grateful. We're thankful. We're appreciative. For him to bring us back in the house. And this is just one of the ways we human. It's all about your appreciation. By just showing up. And being patient.
Young adult choir is going to be Thursday evening at 6 o'clock. All young adult members are Continue, Lord God, to bless us and keep us and strengthen and encourage us. As we continue to press our way your way,
which is the way, the truth, and the life. We pray your blessings upon this community, not on our own hands, that has befallen upon you. May have been touched by the hands of angels, but we know by lifting up before you, you're sanctified, you're cleansed. You made it in such a state where you're able to receive it back unto yourself. And that's what we want. That's the end that we want. We want to be received back unto you for our works, our doings, our deeds, our acts, and our actions. In the mighty, precious name of Jesus, we do indeed pray and give thanks in Jesus' name. Amen. This is the bread that represents the body of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, which was bruised for the remission of all of our sins. Let us eat. Worship and praise God. And immediately after our last worship and praise song, consider yourself dismissed.